My name is Jonathan Hurst, and I'm an assistant professor here at Oregon State in mechanical, industrial, manufacturing, engineering. But my work does span across electrical and computer science as well. We do robotics here in the lab, and specifically physical interaction tasks. The theme of the lab is understanding what we call passive dynamics, and that is the mechanical components of the robot. So you'll see on this machine, for example, there's these are our springs. These are fiberglass springs, and these are the same purpose as your tendons. They're very stretchy and flexible. So when this thing is hopping up and down, a lot of that energy is going into and out of those springs as part of energy storage. And that really enables the behavior of the device. If we didn't have these springs and it were just motors attached to the leg, it would not be physically possible to hop up and down or to run efficiently, no matter what software you wrote, or no matter what sort of controls you had. Our big focus right now is building robots that can walk and run outside in the real world over reasonably rugged terrain. But we're going to want robots to always be working with humans, around humans, in human environments, and even on humans. I mean, we're talking about legged locomotion applies directly to prosthetic limbs, to exoskeletons that can help disabled people get around, or for military applications so the soldiers can carry a lot more or go farther. So this is our very first prototype of Atreus is the name of this machine. It's a monopod robot, means just a single leg. It's been designed specifically to match a very simple mathematical model, which looks a lot like a pogo stick. It's just a mass on top of a spring. And that model has been used to describe animal locomotion and has been investigated by a lot of mathematicians and controls people. So what we'd like to do is make a machine that matches this model as closely as possible so that we can control it, we can understand it, and so on. We built this based on what I learned doing my PhD work at Carnegie Mellon University at the Robotics Institute, building Thumper here. So Thumper is also a monopod, and this, as part of my PhD work, I had hopping around the room there. Things that I learned from this, we were able to apply to the design of Atreus. Thumper was also built into a bipedal version, so just two of these legs, exactly the same, put together. And that robot is named Mabel and is at the University of Michigan. One of the things that impressed me when I arrived here is that Oregon State students know how to build stuff. This place is really great for applied engineering. And students can not only, you know, do the math and the analysis, but they know how to weld and machine and put together a device that is going to function and work. And that's really been helpful. That works well. That's a good fit for me. It's a good fit for this lab. That sort of culture doesn't exist everywhere. A lot of times now when I watch science fiction movies, it's just ruined because all the technical parts are wrong. You know, it's just, and it's hard when it eliminates my suspension of disbelief. I can't do it anymore when I say, well, the whole premise of the movie is flawed, so this is dumb. We want to have robots moving and doing things. I'd like to be in here when there's a robot hopping around and an arm moving over there, and you know, every week we're taking the thing outside, maybe to the practice football field once we've got this off the boom and in 3D. You know, we're running a test and the robot's going to run around for a while and then something breaks. We bring it back to the lab, we work on it for a week, we take it back out again. That's where I want to be.